121 prisoners we took today.
Fuck!
Had our enemies 121 prisoners of ours, I imagine their deaths would be swift and cruel.
I beg your pardon, my lord, but have I not proved to you my friendship? At great personal risk to myself and my interests, I made enemies of the pirates in order to ensure your success.
Made enemies of them? Well, they've been my enemies for some time now. Are you saying that they haven't been yours?
May I suggest
that... I thank you for your aid today. It is, I believe, to be expected. Today, tomorrow, every day, till the war is won.
The Underhill Plantation, and it's home to well over 200 slaves. It's well defended. Until now, I haven't had the manpower to take it. But now, with the men we have here, I think it's possible. And if we could convince even half of those slaves to join our fight, we might then actually be in a position to take back
Jesse. So, or you're suggesting we don't have time for that?
I prepared these men to follow Long John Silver upon his return. Now, if you assume that in his absence that role now reverts to you, then you assume wrong.
You're forgetting one thing. Somewhere on an island a few days' journey from here is a chest filled with treasure buried in a secret place. And of the three men who know of that place, I may be the last one alive after today.
Are you threatening to withhold the location of the chest that every man here is counting upon to provide for Nassau's treasury once we secure it? Solely so you can maintain your own status here.
There is an unthinkable victory within our reach. And I will see this through by whatever means I have at my disposal.
Three men know the resting place of the chest, and one woman. He told it to me before we left home.
It would be preferable if there were one voice to govern here tomorrow. But I don't think it's going to be quite so simple. There will be no pirate king here. Of that much, I am certain.
You had to do all this extra shit. Like, why couldn't you just go to the top?
When was the last time you fought in a vanguard? He ain't never gonna see you in that way. Teach.
No, he want him to, but it ain't ever gonna happen.
When I was in that carriage with the governor, when your horses first appeared, I had a chance to end it all. I had my hands around his neck. Had I done more in that moment, had I been more in that moment,
Charles would still be here.
I know how you felt about him. I felt the same way, and you know it. But he's dead. And I can't see what fucking sense it makes to keep trying to make him happy. And all it's actually going to lead to is you joining him.
What did he do?
Set a course for Nassau. To send a message when we return that this can all end if the governor turns over the one thing he wants.
Eleanor. Please don't get captured. Please don't get captured. Please don't fucking get captured.
Oh my god. Long John Silver. Welcome home.
Oh. Awesome, awesome start to the season. I already knew that Silver was going to make it, but I still had a little bit of anxiety. Hopefully, by what that guy said, he's a good guy, or like, obviously a pirate. I'm pretty doubtful that the governor will actually give in to Blackbeard's request. I feel like he's relying on her too much now, and basically he's not going to betray her like that. Even though I really, really want him to. Flint and his freaking ego, I swear, it gets him into trouble every single time. It was just like, dude, how can you not be understanding? Billy has been there. Exactly everything that he said. He has drank with them, bled with them, fucking raided with them, you know what I mean? He needs to be more understanding with that. It doesn't make any sense to me how he just doesn't get it. Well, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.